You're listening to Hump Day News and Rumors on Mousecapades Radio.
Get ready for something
majestic.
The following is an original production of the Mousecapades Radio Network.
Now, from the Mousecapades Studios, here are your hosts.
Happy Hump Day, Mousecapades listeners. This is Vicki, and I'm here with Stephanie, Rebecca, and Samantha, and we hope that you're all staying safe, happy, and healthy. This is episode 858, and you're listening to the number one podcast that entertains that space between your ears, the Mousecapades and More podcast.
Just a reminder that those of us on the Mousecapades and More podcast are travel agents, so if you are looking to book a trip, we would be glad to help. You could text Vicki, Rebecca, Samantha, or myself, Stephanie, at 636-373-4497, and we would be happy to get with you to design a magical vacation. A small refundable deposit of $200 will hold your resort and ticket package, so contact one of us today.
All right, so this week at Disneyland Resort, they celebrated the opening of San Francisco Square at Disney California Adventure Park. We did get to see some of this, but it was not finished when we were there, sadly. When I went back to look at the pictures this weekend, Steph, I noticed that they finished painting the bridge that's supposed to be the San Francisco Bridge, but it's the San Francisco Bridge. It was white in my pictures, and I guess I didn't realize that they had not painted it red like the San Francisco Bridge. But it's San Francisco, for those of you that may or may not know, if you don't know that movie, is an alternative universe for the movie Big Hero 6. If you've not watched it, it definitely is a movie that should be watched. It was put out 3 months after Frozen and kind of lost its hoopla, and I'm really pushing for kids to watch that movie again. In that area, guests can now enjoy some Asian cuisine, like Hero's aunt sells in the movie. They can meet Baymax and Hiro Hamada. And I got to watch one of the vloggers I watched was doing videoing when they came out for the first time. And it was really cool to see. It was cool for me as an adult. So I can only imagine what a kid's thinking. I've seen Baymax in person, but I've never seen him with Hiro. And that was pretty amazing. This real life person being Hiro. They have exclusive Big Hero 6 merch in that area. And while we were in California, we just did see it. But it didn't get completed in time. They were supposed to open on Thursday, August 31st. Unfortunately, it officially opened on September the 1st. So...
oh, not bad.
It's up and running and cool. Makes us want to go back to Disneyland now.
I saw a video today of some of the food and it looks amazing.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Good deal.
They had some of they were ramen bowls.
Oh, uh-huh.
But they looked so good.
Yum. Normally when Disney was behind on something, they're really behind. So just today is not bad at all.
For sure.
Good job, Disney. You almost did it. Speaking of things opening back, well, not back up, but up for the first time, something I'm super excited about is over at Epcot and Disney World, it's Journey of Water that was inspired by Moana. It's not open for public yet. However, they have had some cast member previews happening, and the pictures that they are posting, have you guys seen any of them?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. We cannot wait to see this area. The landscape and the water combined just makes it breathtaking. It's also nice that some of those lovely walls have been removed and it's just easier to get around. I read a post personally where a cast member was saying that they could stay there all day and just enjoy the peacefulness of everything. Now, the only bummer is it's just cast member previews right now. And so Disney Vacation Club members and annual pass holders are kind of wondering if they're going to get a preview or not, because that has not been shared. It also hasn't been shared when the official open date is. We've kind of been told late fall, who knows, October maybe. That's kind of what I keep hearing pop up, but there's absolutely nothing official from Disney about that. People are just assuming that it might be open sometime in October. As soon as they have those official dates, we will let you know.
Yeah, so I haven't received any emails since annual pass holder. I wasn't even thinking about that. And I was like, oh, no, I cannot go again. I'm already going too much this year. But that was the first thing I thought of. If they give me a preview, I have to go to that.
Yeah,
it's true.
No, I do not.
They have like two, like you can go like a wet way or a dry way, like a pathway to get there.
Oh. That's neat.
I haven't seen that part.
They shared like a video I saw also on Instagram, Disney Parks, and it was kind of like a quick little preview, and like the water is musical.
Oh, fun.
I saw that.
There's like one area that you can put your hand under, and it looks like, I guess, some of the water is controlled by movement.
Oh, cool.
And then you could hear some of the music playing, and it sounds, you know, like the soundtrack from Moana playing.
That's cool. Oh, cool.
I saw the musical water, and I wondered how that worked.
I think they had to get like a patent for that.
Well, they have the thing at Figment where you move your hands and then it makes music and plays like different right. instruments. So maybe it's the same concept only with water. Very cool.
Maybe. Well, we shared earlier this year with you that the Disney Dining Plan will be returning on January 9, 2024. Disney has now released some more information about the Disney Dining Plan. There are two distinct dining plans, the Quick Service Plan and the Standard Disney Plan. The Quick Service Plan will allow each guest to get two quick service meals per day, plus one snack or non-alcoholic drink. They will also receive a resort refillable mug. Guests under 21 choose a non-alcoholic beverage, but guests over 21 may choose an alcoholic beverage with their meal. The Standard Disney Plan also allows guests to receive a quick service meal plus a table service and a beverage with each meal. Again, guests under 21 will choose non-alcoholic beverages, but guests over 21 may choose to have an alcoholic beverage with their meals. The plan will give guests a resort refillable mug, and guests now can purchase the dining plan with their Disney packages, or if they are Disney Vacation Club members, they can purchase the plan.
Which is new.
Yeah, I have a thought though. So looking at the prices, it seems like the price for children kind of stayed the same or went down, but the price for adults went up.
26%.
And I feel like that's to accommodate the alcoholic beverage.
You may be right.
I think they had that, though, the last time, because I remember getting the plan and having the alcohol.
They did.
But they also took a snack away because yes. It used to be two snacks.
Right. So I'm just wondering, like, on not all cruises, but a lot of cruises, you have to pay extra if you want alcoholic beverages or even if you want like colas and things. So I'm wondering if Disney couldn't save money and make those things extra, but that's just my opinion.
I don't want to poo-poo it because I know we've talked about the fact that it makes it all inclusive. And when you get there, because for years, that's what we did. However, I do know when I went in March, the three of us nowhere near spent, $95 or something. So my mom and Kaylee and I nowhere near spent over $270 in a day for food. Right. And that's how much it would be if I did that plan. And so I'm just going to, for now, unless something changes, I'm not taking that plan. I mean, Jean just said she's going to do it anyway.
We're doing it too.
The plan is great if you do plan on drinking. Well, maybe not great, but I mean, if you plan on drinking those beverages, those do add up. And I think maybe that's why like not everywhere had alcohol, like such a selection of alcoholic beverages too. Mm-hmm. That's kind of a becoming more common. Every single restaurant, even the quick service restaurants, like you can get, I mean, not all of them, but a lot of them, you can get an alcoholic beverage now, where that wasn't as common a long time ago. So I don't know. I think that could be also why just the prices are going up and why they've changed. Because before, was it the quick service? I didn't think you could get an alcoholic beverage with the quick service dining plan.
You could, yeah. It, right before the pandemic. Yeah. Okay. They changed it like the year before.
Okay. But it was before that, it wasn't. And they changed it for like a year.
Correct.
Gotcha.
And I think we're still going to do it. I don't know that Steve and I will do it when we go. But I know when we take my mom, we're going to do it because we're going to be doing some character meals
because sure.
She's never been before. But I don't know. I don't know that the price will work out for us.
We're doing it for the character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
because with us, you know, we have, you know, two little ones, and Chase and Natalia will be very different possibly on what they want to see, if it's princesses or the regular characters. So that we know is something that's going to add up.
Sure. Yes.
Eventually. Like, yeah, if you look at how much that is per day, if we're doing maybe one a day. Mm-hmm. But I mean, yeah, I could see, though, if you're not planning on doing any sit downs, if you're just doing more quick services and stuff like that, I don't think it might be worth it in the end.
It really does depend on where you go. But you're right. If you're doing the characters, for sure. If you're planning to do Be Our Guest, for sure. Hoop-de-doo review, you get your money's worth there, because it's, you're paying for the entertainment and the food. I think it's $75 a person if you sit on the floor.
Is that a 2-credit one, though? Hoop-de-doo?
I don't know if it came back to a 2-credit. It was prior to the pandemic, but I haven't seen like the little chart. That would be something definitely for us to cover.
They added storybook dining, which is one of my favorites. Snow White, that is now a 2-credit.
Yeah,
where I think before that it was just a 1.
I saw that. I just don't remember them it being Hoop-de-doo review. And I know Hoop-de-doo review used to be 1. So, but maybe I just overlooked it.
I will look while you're going on to the next story.
Frontierland closed at Disney World's Magic Kingdom. On Sunday, September 3rd, guests were able to go to Tomorrowland, Fantasyland, Adventureland, and Liberty Square. But Eric Chu shared on Twitter Sunday afternoon that something was up in Frontierland. The pictures he posted showed cast members blocking the way to Frontierland before the Country Bear show, and a truck was on the road in the background. Apparently, cast members were also blocking the other end of Frontierland near Pico's Bills. This allowed guests to still be able to ride Big Thunder Mountain via the route from Adventureland. While nothing was announced, it appeared that the truck was a pump truck. A truck like this would typically be used if there was a sewer issue. We will keep you updated, but we are hoping whatever the problem is can be fixed quickly.
I am still looking, but I will come back to it after I do a story. Yeah, I didn't see any updates on that. Did anybody else see any updates today about that truck?
No,
I didn't.
No, but I would assume that if there aren't any more stories, then it's back open.
Right.
Because we would be hearing that.
You think that they would tell us some things, I think, are secret that shouldn't be a secret. And then, like, if you're having a sewer problem, that's a real life problem everywhere. It's not like
somebody
died. That's my fear, was I was like, oh my gosh, somebody died over there. And so they've got a block. You know, my mind went to the worst. Not that the sewer problem is not a bad problem, but it's also
fixable.
Much better than me thinking that somebody got there and was kidnapping somebody, or somebody had died. Or, I mean, that's where my mind went, and that's bad. I realize that I don't need to do that, but social media has made me that way. So Walt Disney Studios Park in France features an impressive nighttime drone show. And if you guys have not looked at that on YouTube, I would encourage you to. This time inspired by the world of Marvel Cinematic Universe. It's lighting up the skies above the Avengers campus and the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. The Avengers Power of the Night combines state-of-the-art projections, pyrotechnics, and about 500 drones. That's right, 500. The show originally wrapped up its run earlier this year, but made a triumphant return on September the 1st. The high-tech Avengers Spectacular is now set to perform until January the 7th, 2024. And it's even received a few updates since its first run. But it looked pretty cool.
That looks like something I for sure need to show Teddy.
Yeah, I would say.
Yeah.
Yes, you would need to show Teddy that. For his birthday, but he's in bed now.
Right. I can hear them talking up there, so he's not sleeping yet.
He's like, I can't believe I'm 5 already. How did this happen?
He kept waking up going, I just don't know if I'm 5 yet. And I'm like, go back to sleep. I wasn't sure if I was 5 yet.
Oh,
all right. So Disney's California Adventure is celebrating Dia de los Muertos, which is Day of the Dead. It's going to return to the Plaza de la Familia in Paradise Gardens Park. The plaza is open from September 1st and it goes all the way through November 2nd. And it features specialty food, yum, and some souvenirs. And it also has a musical celebration of Coco. This street show happens outside of Goofy's Sky School in front of the Plaza de la Familia archway. Periodically throughout the day is when you can see the show. Here is how Disney is talking up the festival. And they said, Enjoy a heartwarming tale of the entertaining storytellers of Plaza de la Familia that celebrates popular songs from the Disney and Pixar film Coco, including Remember Me, the Oscar-winning Best Original Song. The show features singing, dancing, and life-size puppets. At the following times daily, there's an 11:30, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6:30, 7:30, and 8:30 show. Sounds like a lot of fun. And there's plenty of chances for you to catch it. So make sure to put that one on your calendar.
And why can't we have Coco in Disney World?
I know.
When I was in Disney, though, in June, at Disney World at Epcot, inside the Mexican Pavilion, there were a lot of different artists doing things for the Day of the Dead celebration. And they even had some people there making the sugar skulls. It was very, very cool to watch.
Yeah. I love that they have it there. I would love to see all the characters like they do. All right. I'm going to go back to the story with the dining plan.
Yeah, dining plan.
Two table service credits are required for Cinderella's Royal Table, which is from before. I don't know. I don't remember if this one was on it, but Princess Storybook Dining at Akershus Royal Banquet Hall at Epcot in Norway Pavilion. Like Samantha said, Storybook Dining at Artist Point with Snow White is now two. Be Our Guest is two credits. Hoop-Dee-Doo Review is two credits. If you do private in-room dining at Grand Floridian, which I will not be partaking of, but if you do that, that will be two credits. And if you go to fine signature dining, which I think is like Victoria and Albert's and Citrico's, I'm trying to think of all those. So those all will have for sure two table. They take two table service meals. Excuse me.
Okay.
All right, well, Muppet Vision 3D at Hollywood Studios is an amazingly funny and iconic show. If you haven't seen it, you may not realize that it really hasn't had any changes since 1991, which has made a lot of us wonder if Muppet Vision 3D is going to withstand time. Currently, there are walls around the courtyard of the Muppets Vision 3D attraction, but the show is still open to guests. The walls have brought about a lot of conversation. Some fear that we may be losing Kermit, Miss Piggy, Gonzo, and the gang. Some are guessing that Disney is starting to prepare for the Jollywood Nights fun, but it seems a little soon to be setting up for that. Multiple users suggest that a new food stall or Jeffrey's location is being built as part of the Muppet Courtyard makeover, although this has not been confirmed. Either way, it's generating suspicion and intrigue from Disney guests. I'll be very sad if Muppet 3D is gone.
Me too.
It's like my favorite show.
If they want to update it, great. Update away.
Absolutely.
It's in desperate need of an update. It's so empty back there. Like, they used to have a Christmas store before the pandemic. There used to be a little Christmas store. There used to be, I think, just like a regular gift shop.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's nothing. It's like it's hidden. Right. And I feel like people just like kind of walk past it now to go to Galaxy's Edge.
There's never a wait ever.
No.
But it is my favorite. I always say, go to that one. If you need to get out of the sun, that's my favorite one.
It is good.
Yeah. The theater, though, does need an upgrade. Some of the seats and some of the walls are starting to look a little rough. So,
oh, yeah. And just like Samantha said, the space around it, there's nothing over there. So there's really no reason for you to just wander over there and be like, I think I'll watch a show.
When Bob Iger returned as CEO after Bob Chapek was fired, everyone, including the employees and myself, thought that Disney would be saved. Unfortunately, Iger has become one of the most hated people in business right now. While Disney and the other industry studios refuse to negotiate on wages and residual pay, Disney has apparently opened up a position for a senior executive to lead crisis communication response efforts in an effort to help retain and motivate employees. The job listing offers candidates over $330,000 and is reportedly not new, but is the result of an internal move. It's a harsh blow to the employees asking for more livable wages and comes just a few months after Iger called their demands unrealistic. He was also rumored to be the executive saying that they are willing to wait until union members start losing their apartments and houses. How do we all feel about this?
Sad.
Mm-hmm.
Harsh.
when he returned, it was, you know, so exciting. Everyone was ready for the changes, and you saw a few, a little bit here mm-hmm. and there, but this is just a little ridiculous.
Well, since this negotiation, and I don't know, Steph, if you have Charter cable, but do you have Charter cable?
I didn't even know we had cable for like the last couple of years. I thought we didn't have it like after we got married. And then I've been saying we still don't have it. And apparently we do now. And I don't know when that happened.
Oh.
So we have cable of some sort now.
We have cable. And, you know, Freeform is related or has something to do with Disney. Did you see this, Rebecca? All weekend, every time a Disney movie came on, there was a banner running across saying that our cable company tried to make a good, fair deal with Disney. And until that deal could be reached, their content would not be shown. And it was like that on several ESPN channels. And we went to exercise yesterday at Planet Fitness, and the majority of their channels are blocked out now because I guess they're run by Disney. And so like there were limited things that I could watch. Now I got lucky because the movie that was on Freeform at the time was Hotel Transylvania. So that's not a Disney movie. So it played. But as soon as it was over, I was on the treadmill and then that thing popped up again because it was supposed to be The Incredibles. And I was like, oh my gosh, Bob Iger, you got to get this under control. All right. It's mine and Stephanie's favorite thing to talk about. It's September, and we all know what that means. New cookies at Gideon's Bakehouse and cakes. Sadly, Gideon's at Disney Springs was closed for part of September 1st and all day on the 2nd because they did not have air conditioning. So they were back working again on Sunday. The first September cookie is Bonnie's cookie, and this is a lemon poppy crumb cookie. If you love lemons and muffins, this is the cookie for you. It's lemon poppy seed cookie filled with poppy seeds and bits of white chocolate. It's then covered in lemon butter crumb and thin sugar glaze. They also brought my favorite cookie back, and I'm not going for a month. It's the Stewart cookie, and he has the orange pecan and chocolate chip cookie that I didn't think I would love, and it is probably one of my favorites. This is a vanilla bean chocolate chip cookie that's infused with orange and topped with dark chocolate. It has South Florida pecan pralines and candy orange peel. And I just put on here, I'm sad I'm going to miss it. It's delicious every single year you can get it. So if you see it, get it. It's good, I promise.
So have you tried the lemon poppy crumble?
I'm sure it's good. It was never there when I was there.
It sounds amazing. I was just wondering. Mm-hmm.
So do the cakes that Steph's going to tell
us
about.
I was like doing this while you're reading it. And while I was reading it, I'm like, oh my gosh, these sound so good.
I know.
Ugh, Gideon's, why do you do this to me? So the cake is going to go right along with the cookies that Vicky was talking about. There's the lemon crumble cake to go along with that lemon poppy crumb cookie. It has three layers of lemon poppy seed cake. They're iced with lemon buttercream frosting with lemon pearls in the frosting. And then there's the orange pecan chocolate cake that matches that orange pecan chocolate chip cookie. It has three layers of chocolate cake layered with dark chocolate frosting, candied pecans, and sugared orange peel. If you're going to be in Orlando, we think that you should make a quick trip to Disney Springs and grab these cookies and cakes. You won't be disappointed, and we will be jealous.
Yes.
Then you can maybe text us and tell us how good they were.
Yes. Feel free to come on and we'll share you how you're feeling. And I didn't see if the orange cold brew is back, but listeners, if the orange cold brew is back with those cookies, oh, they're paired beautifully together. It's just a sickness at this point, I think.
That sounds delicious. Our next story is about Teddy's favorite ride, Test Track. Recently, Test Track had an abrupt stop, which left people on the ride stuck in one spot, and guests that were waiting had two choices. Number one, they could wait it out until the ride began working again, or number two, they could leave the line. The guests on the ride had to wait for cast members to make their decision. Some guests were stopped in a very uncomfortable stop. Where the cars reached their top speed on Test Track is where some guests were stopped on their trip. It is where the road appears to be almost on its side, and the car gives the appearance that it could flip. Ooh. So I'm wondering if it was in the spot where you're moving the fastest, did it just like come suddenly like
And then it stopped.
Wow.
That's what, and they showed it in the picture, but the car was like, I don't know if it was on two wheels, but that's what it looked like in the picture. And I was like, that would be scary.
That would be scary. Anywhere else, I'd be fine with it. But yeah, outside, first of all, outside in the heat, because isn't that part outside?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That would not be fun. And then that angle would definitely be a little bit scary.
Plus add in September with even end of August, like not just the heat, but like the rainstorms that just pop up.
Yeah. This week, I didn't on purpose forget, but I had clients at Disney and they called me on Tuesday. They waited till it was after school hours, but we were auditioning kids for the after school program. And they're like, can you talk? Is this a bad time? And I'm like, well, I can leave Kaylee in here, but just give me a second to get out of this room. Cause I think there were 45 kids there that day trying out. So I went out into the hallway and I asked, I said, is something wrong? Yes, we need to move our flight up. I wasn't even thinking stuff. I should have been thinking because we just talked about this last
hurricane.
Week. Yeah. And they already heard that the Tampa airport had closed and they wanted to get tickets to come home before they got stuck. So yeah.
Did they get home?
They did.
Good.
I told him to check in with me, but then I had to be the nagging mother and message because he's my son's friend. And so I was like, hello, please tell me you're okay. Cause your mother's going to come and be down my door if you're not. He's like, yes, I'm home. Thank you so much.
Mm-mm.
I'm just sad because I had talked them into doing the late flight home. So they had that whole other day to go to Disney Springs. So I don't think they got to go to Disney Springs and just shop and try things. Means they'll have to go back.
All rats.
The Disneyland monorail reopened this week from its refurbishment. The most noticeable changes of the renovation are an updated monorail station in the downtown Disney district and an overall smoother ride experience. Track work has been done, and it's obvious that the entire path has been power washed. The station is now a rich blue tone with white and silver detailing, marking a huge change from the rustic copper and gray colorway that used to be at the station. The Disneyland monorail closed for refurbishment on July 5th with a targeted end date of August 31st, a date it either hit or just missed, depending on perspective. While the monorail didn't reopen on August 31st, that is technically the day the refurbishment was completed. They only missed the date by one day as it was up and running for guests on September 1st.
Which means Steph and I have to go back now. Because we didn't get to ride that.
Again, rats.
Steph's like, first we have to talk Keith into it. And then.
That's the second time we've heard that they've only been a day off.
Right. And it's September 1st. September's a good month, I guess.
Sounds like Disneyland knows how to make time, like their deadlines.
They move a little faster over there.
Yeah. So like Matt has 13 days till Disneyland and we have 39 days until Disney World. So it's getting close. So I just want to give a shout out to all of our listeners. We appreciate you and we love being able to celebrate the magic with you each week. And I'm waiting for one of our listeners to get back with me because they took a trip to Disneyland right after we did, Stephanie. So hopefully to be able to do a trip report on that pretty soon.
That'd be fun. Thank you guys for joining us. If you could go on to Apple or Podbean and give us a rating or comment, it would mean a lot to us. We love hearing from our listeners. Be sure to let us know what you'd like to hear more about because, of course, we are always reshaping our show to cater to your needs.
If you are interested in being a part of our show or you have a question or comment, just text us at 636-373-4497. You can check us out on our social media account, The Mousecapades Podcast on Facebook. And if you would like a free quote, contact Vicki, Stephanie, Samantha, or me, Rebecca, at 636-373-4497.
Be sure to listen to Friday's show. We will be discussing the Disney graveyard, things that were once a huge hit, but now they lay empty and unavailable. As always, thanks for listening to the number one podcast that entertains the space between your ears, The Mousecapades and More Podcast.
Well, girls, I think it's about that time. Disney love.
Second star to the right.
It's a small world after all.
Have a magical day, my friends.
Sail on, silver girl. Sail on by, sail on by. Your time has come to shine. Their way.